What do you think? I say
come
he goes.
Come on down, Stinger!
I say he goes with me.
The moment we have all been waiting for. Let's go. Come on.
I say no.
Don't keep us waiting.
What about you, Oddsman?
I don't know. He's had that poker face. It's just so tough to really get any kind of a feeling at all, any kind of a gut feeling.
Oh, you just don't want to commit yourself. Wishy-washy.
All right, you two shut up. Let's watch this.
Yeah, you shut up.
Stick around and find out what he has to say.
This is really important stuff right here. Oh, I think that may have been an answer. It was a WCW loogie.
Oh, look at that.
And he's choking Sting. The Giant is choking and mauling Sting.
Got him right from behind. Sting shouldn't have spit in the man's face, though.
And then don't turn your back on the largest athlete in pro sports for a relentless attack. Sting is out.
Look at this. Look at this walking towards Sting.
That Giant killer.
Wielding a lead pipe. He's standing over Sting. We got our answer.
I made a decision. Clear and simple. Sunday, you and I, walking into the pay-per-view, we're partners. And if you and I win the belts, which I'm pretty sure we will, come Monday, you're going to have to make a decision.
He's got a black and white shirt for Sting.
Look at the people. They're saying, no, no, no. They're shaking their heads. They don't want to see this.
Sting has a shirt in his hand.
He hasn't said no.
What's he going to do? He does not have to make a decision until after Slammerie. A shock Sting and the Giant, I should say, are the World Tag Team Champs. And the Giant said, Sting, you've got a decision to make. What will that decision be? Oh, I think that may have been an answer.
A Giant killer.
Wielding a lead pipe. He's standing over Sting. We got our answer.
Champions at Slammerie. But as you saw, Sting gave his answer. With that in mind, obviously with a response to what we saw, let's bring him out right now. Truly the biggest member of NWO Hollywood. Here is the Giant. Giant. Okay. With both. Wearing both title belts, I might add. All right. I can be the valet here. Want to talk about what we've just seen in the response by Sting. You told him he had till Monday, and I think we even said it there. He gave his answer that Sting is firmly a part of World Championship Wrestling.
Well, first of all, let me start off by clarifying a few things. Sting and I had a little disagreement. Now, I got a little bit carried away with Sting when he spit in my face. I don't think he fully understand the question I was imposing. So we went back and I tried calling him, and he's a little under the weather right now, that's why he's not here. But the main thing was, I told him I was sorry. You know, I got a little testy, got a little upset, but Sting and I are fine. Hey, we're tag team champs together. He's made the right choice. Sting's NWO all the way, right along with me. Sting and I are the NWO World Tag Team Champions.
Now, I know you say that, but the actions that we saw Monday certainly contradict that.
Well, you know, like I said, that was a little bit of a little bit of frustration, you know? He was upset at me. I didn't talk to him at...
Uh-oh. Lex Luger fans. You know, we're going to need some security out here in a hurry. Remember, Luger came out here to confront Sting when you gave him that choice 1 week ago. I would think he has some sort of response. All right, once again, security. Once again, please come on out here.
All right, Luger says he's cool here.
Security is here, Lex.
You know, Tony, it's a funny thing to hear all that garbage coming out of your mouth, Giant, because I don't know what Sting you talk to. Whoa, whoa, whoa. We don't need all this security and all these wrestlers out here. No need for that, really. Because I just got talking to Sting.
You just talked to Sting?
So I don't know what Sting you talk to, but I know one thing for sure. What you're saying is a total unadulterated lie. Myself and a lot of fans doubted Sting at one time. We made that mistake. We're not going back. Never again. I'm out here because if you want to walk around with those flim-flam belts you got off Kevin Nash with Scott Hall, that's fine. If you walk around with that cheesy black and white shirt, that's fine. But you jumped out on Sting, and now you're lying your you-know-what off. And Giant, I had a main event match later on tonight, but you know what? I've cleared a slate. How about I just make a little challenge? I let you make your singles NWO debut, showcase your Giant self right here in Cleveland, right here on Thunder against the Total Package, Lex Luger.
How about that?
Here we go. That's all well and fine, Lex. That's good. That's good. But once again, I'm gonna give you the same choice I gave Sting. You can make the right choice, or you can make the wrong choice. You and I have been tag champions together. We've run the road together. What's your answer, Lex? Are you gonna be my partner? We're always looking for a few good men. Are you gonna jump on board the team? What's your answer?
How about it, Lex?
Give it a shot.
You know, Tony, I guess my answer is same as Sting.
Whoa!
He gave it a shot right between the eyes.
Oh, my.
Oh, and here come the wrestlers into the ring. There goes Evan Courageous.
Oh.
He's chokeslammed. The Luchadors, Damian and Ciclope, are down. Luger heads to the back.
Silver King. Oh.
Here comes Dandy. What a physical mismatch this is.
Oh! Oh, this is to make sexy right there.
Powerbomb. Power slam on the Viano.
He's just too much, man.
Oh, there's no question. Size does matter. The Giant clears the ring.
You want some of me, Lex? You want some of me? You got some.
There it is. The Giant accepts the challenge of Lex Luger. And we are live from Cleveland, Ohio. You are watching Thunder on the Superstation.
Grab a ball tonight.
Thunder, and I tell you, what a way to begin our program. A lot going on here already tonight. Lee Marshall, Bobby Heenan, Tony Schiavone back with you. You know, Lee, regardless of what the Giant can say, he once again puts on that black and white NWO Hollywood slant on everything. It was crystal clear Monday what Sting had to say, even though Sting and the Giant are World Tag Team Champions together.
I hearken back to the beginning days of the New World Order, Tony. It was Eric Bischoff that started offering people choices with a time limit attached. 30 days, remember? Now Giant gives Sting an option, a choice with a time limit. You're right, Sting's choice was very obvious. Too bad the Giant just didn't appreciate it.
But then things really picked up when Luger came out, and Luger gave Sting, or gave the Giant, the exact same response Sting did. And now, fans, tonight on this program live, Luger and the Giant together, one-on-one, and Luger as much as Sting firmly a part of WCW.
There's a few things you don't do in this world, and Luger, maybe you should learn. You don't call a man a liar, and you don't spit in the face of somebody 7'4", 500 pounds, and then challenge the man. Total package, you may be in the biggest trouble of your life.
Well, I agree, don't spit in the man's face, but it was crystal clear the man lied, Brain. He was just telling the truth. Let's go to the ring, and we'll sort this out here as Luger and the Giant will go one-on-one. He didn't call a man a liar.
I'm not calling him a liar either.
It's the one thing about the Giant. He is not a one-trick pony. Sure, he does have the choke slam, but he's got a lot of other weapons.
7'4", he's 500 pounds.
Weapon enough, you'd think.
Yeah.
A walking weapon. Ooh! Backbreaker.
Come on, are you gonna stop?
Backbreaker, and the referee asks Luger if he wants to continue. Meanwhile, the Giant just slowly, calmly, methodically stalks around the ring. The Giant in the attack again. Oh, jawbreaker, Lex Luger. Luger tried to run the Giant down, but cannot.
He's still standing.
Luger trying to hit the Giant high, and the Giant won't go down.
Luger still throwing the forearms one more time. Well, remember where you were tonight, guys. The night the Giant went down.
Something's happening.
Luger's
Everyone's looking the other way. Whoa.
It's Sting.
Sting has come in.
Can we get a...
Luger's in trouble now. Big trouble.
Oh, my goodness. Now, Luger said he talked to Sting at home on the phone. That can't be Sting. Can we get a good look at him?
No airplane travels that fast.
I don't believe so, but the Giant with a massive choke slam has put Luger down.
Well, look at the T-shirt. The NWO black and white Hollywood Hogan T-shirt on this man.
Now he drapes one across Luger. That can't be Sting.
Well, you can ring the bell till now, till the sun comes up tomorrow morning. That's not Sting.
That is not Sting.
Looks like Sting to me.
No, it's not, Vance. And we've got to go. We're out of time. Live on Thunder.
Hey, yo. Let me start off by talking about one person and one person only. You, Kevin Nash. Would you guys just shut up? I'm trying to make a point here. Now, last Monday, you came out with a pipe and you wanted to save poor little old Sting. Well, that was all well and good, and that's fine, but I'm telling you right now, you're here tonight, you're a yellow-bellied coward.
Wow.
If you leave Conan and the Macho Man in the back, and you bring your not-need self out here right now, it'll be me and you, and I will kick your butt all over this building right now!
Well, that's a challenge for right now to Kevin Nash.
You call yourself Big Sexy? I'm the original Big Sexy! Kevin Nash, if you got any heart, if you got any guts, if you're a man at all, I know you're supposed to have a little concussion. But I don't think so. I think you're just flat out scared. So you got any heart, you got any guts, you got any drive, you bring yourself on ahead and get some of the giant, boy.
And the chant of We Want Nash goes up here at this capacity crowd.
I told you he's a coward, he's not even coming out.
Be very careful what you ask for.
Hey, big boy, you want some of this?
Yeah, I want some. Come on, the ring, I want some.
Nothing I'd like better tonight than take care of Hogan's three fluff boys.
Hey, he's going in. I didn't think Nash was this stupid.
Well, I don't think the man is stupid. I think the man is very, very brave.
And there's a fine line between being brave and being stupid.
He decks Adams. Here they go. Giant and Nash.
Yeah, but there's three against one.
That's exactly what they wanted, and they got the advantage on Big Sexy. Three on one.
Here come the reserves. Lex Luger. What? That's Lex Luger with a tap.
And Luger came out with Conan. What's he doing?
Luger, Hennig.
What is Luger doing out there?
I don't know. What, with Savage and Conan and Kevin Nash?
Don't tell me Luger's got an NWO shirt on under that.
The fans are standing in disbelief. And I think the Giant is as shocked as anyone.
I'm with them.
Luger came out. Remember, Luger had the offer from... Oh, my God. Oh, he was tossed a Wolfpack shirt.
He's considering it.
The same thing happened to Sting. Remember, the Giant offered him the white and the black, and he turned him down. And Luger made sure he turned him down. Oh, look at that!
I don't believe this!
Lex Luger has become a member of the Wolfpack. Apparently, he's NWO! He's got a team with Sting.
Tony, that's the first question that comes to your mind. What does Sting think about this?
Tonight, Luger and Sting to team against the Giant and the NWO Hollywood Sting. Sting turned him down. Luger did not.
I think Nash has a proposition.
I'm sure he does. Will Sting wear the red and the black?
What do you think, guys?
I don't know.
I think he will. Luger's did it. He's going to do it.
Luger thinks so. You can just tell by the look on Luger's face.
There's no way to call it. You only have to just stand back. Sting told me a lot when he backed out of the ring. I don't know if it was a distrust. He's going back to the ring.
He seemed reluctant for a split second, but now he's headed back up to the apron.
And listen, I think the people want him to. If he wasn't going to, he'd leave. He'd be gone. Something's going through his mind right now. He's got a decision to make.
His best friend is on the other side. What does Sting do?
Should I or shouldn't I?
He's going to the ring.
He's going to do it.
The shirt is out.
He's going to do it.
He's looking at everyone. Look at the face of Sting.
He's shopping. He's looking around.
He's at a crossroads in his life.
If you feel you should, do it. Do it.
It's decision time.
He looks at Luger. Still no emotion. Luger approaching Sting.
Yes, yes or no? Yes or no?
He's got the shirt. It was thrown to him. Is he going to put it on?
He's got the shirt.
Is he going to put it on?
You know that it's true that Nitro is returning to the Omni or the Georgia Dome in Atlanta on July 6th. Monday, July 6th at the Georgia Dome in Atlanta, Nitro returns. Tickets go on sale this Friday in 2 days. At the box office at Ticketmaster, and Diamond Dallas and the Nitro Girl will be the box office at 10 to 11 a.m. We understand this is the new music for the Wolfpack. So let's, I've been told, listen in. New things happening all the time. The Wolfpack gets its newest member. They have brand new theme music. We should have known, Lee, when we heard the wolf howl at the beginning of it right there. Little rap sound to it, and yeah. They come out, and the fans are standing here in Nashville.
Yeah, look who's with him. MC Rap Master Snoop Doggy Luger.
You're not kidding. There he is.
Yeah.
Is that unbelievable? Is that a shocking vision right there or what, Bray?
Yeah, people are talking to me about they're more shocked at that than anything that's happened in professional wrestling that they can remember. And this big man here, the big man, the giant killer, listen to what he has to say.
He's ahead of NWO Wolfpack.
I know the music's sweet, but we gotta cut it for a minute. Nashville, Tennessee, Wolfpack in the house! You know, Macho, I don't know about you, but I just heard Bret Hart running his mouth out here earlier tonight. You got anything you want to say about that?
We got something real important, but there's only one guy that can say it. And I say bottom line, Lex Luger's the man. Oh, yeah.
You ever think in your life you'd see that?
And we really want to hear this. This is very important stuff here.
You know, sometimes in life, you gotta just go by what you feel deep down inside, your gut instinct to do what feels right. Now, Monday night, I could go into 1,000 reasons why I'm out here with this group right now. Because what's happening is bigger than any individual that's out here. The Macho Man, numerous titles, his whole career. K-Dog, the greatest wrestler ever south of the border, another title holder. Big Sexy, titles galore, total package, world titles, U.S. titles, TV titles, you name it. It's all happened right here in this ring right now, and it's happened in this building, and it's happening across the country. Monday night felt right for me. I turned my back on no one. I carried the banner high for WCW for a lot of years. I did not turn my back on them. I still respect them. But something big's happening here, and sometimes in life, when the ship's ready to sail and you gotta make a decision, they say you're gonna go in the ball game. Either you're a player or you're not. And the total package always has been and always will be a player, and that's why I'm in red and black, and that's why I'm in the Wolfpack right now. They feel it too. But more importantly right now, I'm not here to talk about myself or my decision. I'm here to talk about a decision of a guy who I've been with through thick and thin, through family problems, through business problems, through wrestling problems at times. It's even come to blows between him and I, but we have always, each and every time, stuck together, and we've worked it out. And I'm talking to you, Sting. We have always made decisions for others, for the fans, for promoters, for other wrestlers who have stabbed us in the back, but we never made a decision for us. This, Sting, I talked to you Monday night afterwards. I felt it, they felt it, the fans felt it. And you told me you felt it. So Stinger, I took the step, man. I'm asking you, on our friendship and everything that's happened and building here, I'm asking you to please take that step. Do not, for Bret Hart, who knows nothing about you like I do, to come out here and say he's got the key to your future makes me sick to my stomach. So Stinger, you can take that step and come on board. And I've been a part of some big things in my career, going back some big groups, but you're gonna become a part of the strongest, the most powerful, the most awesome force that has ever assembled and come together. Because as the big man, Big Sexy, Mach and K-Dog have always said, the red and black, you're gonna have to help me with this. I've been wanting to say this for a long time. Bring me along on this. Is just too strong. Come on, Sting.
You know, I don't want to take sides, but more than what Bret Hart had to say, you really got the feeling. You knew that Luger was talking to the Hart right there when he was talking to Sting. Look at that sign. Join us, Sting. What will Sting do? There's the plea from NWO Wolfpack. And we'll have more live on Thunder on TBS after this timeout.
Tonight we're going to break out a new version of the survey. How many people in Washington, D.C. came to see Hollywood Hogan and the White and Black? Or how many people tonight came to see the Red and Black Attack, the Wolfpack. Hey, Total Package, you take over for me, big dog. You know, Big Sexy, I'm seeing a whole lot of red and black in this building. And I hope somebody else is seeing a lot of red and black in this building right now. He's been a good friend of mine for a long, long time. And we all know who he is. Who am I talking about? Now, Sting, wherever you are, I haven't heard from you yet, and the Wolf Pack's still waiting. The ship's sailing. Take the step. Now, Stinger, you have always been around winners. I've been a winner. You've been a winner. And now the Red and Black and the Wolf Pack is a group of winners. So the choice is obvious. Stinger, just take that step to the Red and Black and the Wolf Pack. It's that simple. I'm asking you, I'm pleading with you, make the right choice. Now, if you need any reinforcement, the Wolf Pack tonight in the back of the limo having a lot of fun, I might add, in the back of the limo, decided to set a little example for you tonight about where it's at between red and black or black and white. So we decided to put together a little match tonight. Now this match goes out to anybody in white and black, but in particular, that movie setting, Hollywood jet flying limousine riding Hollywood Hogan. And it goes out to the giant, the best that the black and white has to offer against the best that the red and black has to offer. Now, of course, it's hard to choose who's best amongst the red and black because we're all sweet. So we had to draw straws, and wouldn't you know it, Big Sexy and myself, later on tonight, open challenge, we'll make an example for the whole world to see, but most importantly, for you, Sting, for you to see, so you make the right choice of where it's at with the red and black. So black and white, NWO, the Wolf Pack and the red and black have thrown down the gauntlet. Let's see what you got.
Just want to finish it off by saying, being in Washington, D.C. and hanging with the Wolf Pack is just too
giant. Fans, I am standing here with James J. Dillon. And J.J., we saw you arrive in the limousine. Good to see you with some of the great athletes in WCW, like DDP, Booker T, and of course, the unblemished Goldberg. And I feel like sometimes I've been the lone spokesman for WCW. We've all been really tied up in this NWO Wolfpack, NWO Hollywood, wanting Sting to go to their side. But as it stands right now, Sting's still with WCW. And certainly if we go back over the years, he has always been with WCW. And I know you, this is something you'd like to address as well.
Tony, I stand here alone tonight, but I know that I have a lot of support. And it has really pained me to see Sting torn in so many directions by so many people. And as a spokesman for WCW, I certainly can't promise Sting that if he remains with us that he's going to go to Hollywood and he's going to be a big movie star and stand side by side with the likes of Hollywood Hogan. I can't promise Sting that if he stays with WCW that he's going to be so cool that when people see him, they're going to say he's sweet. And I know that last year was a troubling year for Sting, that he thought the whole world had turned their backs on him, including myself and WCW. But I think we proved that we stood behind him. We got him the match that he wanted so badly, and in his finest hour, we were standing there with him side by side. Sting, if you stay with us, remember, you're a legacy at WCW. You're the franchise for WCW. And if you stay with us, we will always, always stay with you.
And his finest hour was right here in this building at the MCI Center when he became the World Heavyweight Champion. As the old cliche goes, the ball is in his court. What will Sting do? It's awfully tough, though, knowing that his closest friend, Lex Luger, is now with the Red and the Black.
I know he's got a big decision to make. He's got a lot on his mind, but it sickens me to see the likes of Hollywood Hogan carrying the WCW Championship title belt. I want to see that title come back where it rightfully belongs, around someone carrying the WCW banner, and I would like for that person to be Sting.
Thanks a lot, James J. Dillon. The clock continues to count. What decision will Sting make? And will he make that later on here tonight? Let's go to Mike Tenay. As they stand.
Something's happening.
On the throat of Kevin Nash from the upper reaches of the MCI Center. Here he comes. Slowly descending, as he has so many times. Sting unhooks. A good look will tell you, yes, that is the real Sting.
Didn't go to his friend Luger at all. Did you notice that?
It is decision time here.
Let's see what he's got on.
He's got an NWO. He's got on the block of the white.
Oh.
My God, he's got on the block of the white.
And look at Hogan celebrate.
Oh, I thought I'd never see this.
Sting hugging Hogan. No, he doesn't. Sting decked Hogan. Sting is going to slam the giant.
He's going to slam the giant.
513 pounds of the giant.
Hold on.
He's getting rid of that black and white right now.
Sting takes off. He's got the red and the black. Sting!
He's joined Nash. He's with the black and red. There's no doubt about that now.
Sting is on the Wolfpack side. Sting is a member of the Wolfpack.
Maybe the strongest organization going today.
Here he comes. He's got an NWO. He's got on the block of the white.
And look at Hogan celebrate.
Oh, I thought I'd never see this.
Sting hugging Hogan. No, he doesn't. Sting decked Hogan. Sting is going to slam the giant. He's got the red and the black. Sting.
He's joined Nash. He's with the black and red. There's no doubt about that now.
Up with the players, but tonight we'll try to make some logic
about what's gone down. Hi, everybody. Tony Schiavone, the one and only Brain Bobby Heenan, Stagger Lee Marshall. Staggering is the word, Lee, because it shocked us all when Sting descended Monday from the upper reaches of the arena and became part of the Red and the Black NWO Wolfpack.
I know a lot of people all around the world are trying to figure out the reason behind the affiliation of Sting with the Wolfpack. I don't think it has anything to do with a Red and Black fashion statement. I can give you five words: the total package, Lex Luger.
That's a good point. His best friend, of course, first across, stepped across the line, and then Sting joined suit just this past Monday.
I think a lot of it has to do with Kevin Nash, the Giant Killer, Big Sexy. Big Sexy helped him just a couple weeks before that, just helped him out. He realizes now he can trust Luger. Now Sting knows he can trust Nash.
Trust a big part of it. Fans, tonight, Goldberg, the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, will defend his belt live here on Thunder, and will continue the best of seven series between Chris Benoit and Booker T. Here's what's happened in the first four matches thus far. Well, the sound of that music, pretty much you can distinguish who it is now. That's the music of NWO Hollywood. The Wolfpack, of course, has its own music now. It's brand new theme song. They come out to distinctive sides. Battle lines, we say the old cliche many times. Battle lines drawn, there's no question. The line in the sand distinctively between black and red, black and white, and the Giant wearing both belts. And that brings up a very interesting thing. And that thing is when Sting became NWO Wolfpack. You have one half of the tag team champs Brain on NWO Wolfpack, the other half on NWO Hollywood, and here he is, the Giant.
Well, I think it's time now that J.J. Dillon takes his feet off the desk, sits upright in that chair, and makes a decision here. Something's got to be done.
I don't want to argue with you all night, but James J. Dillon proved to us on Monday he wasn't sitting behind a desk with his feet propped up. He made a very passionate plea towards Sting to stay in WCW. It didn't work, but J.J. is out there shaking the trees and the bushes, so to speak.
Well, like I said, take your feet off the desk and do something.
Why do I argue with you?
I don't know. Why do we do?
The one thing everybody's got to be convinced of, I think, is that there's no way Sting and this man, the Giant, are ever going to team again, regardless of the fact that they're champions. What is going to happen to the most prestigious tag team titles in our sport?
A decision has to be made. That's JJ's job.
Hey, yo. You know, it seems like here lately, everybody's been making a lot of decisions. Now, we talk about Sting making a decision.
One name and the crowd erupts.
First decision that Sting made, he decided he was going to wear red and black. Well, I got news for you, Sting. Red and black are not your colors. You never look good in red and black, and you never will look good in red and black. That decision, I can live with. The one decision I can't live with, the one decision that neither one of us can live with, is when you stuck your nose in our business and you picked me up and body slammed me on national TV. That I cannot and will not ever let happen again. Now, another thing, you and I both know these world tag team belts that I'm carrying, I'm big enough to carry them both. And you, being the little coward that you are,
wow,
I've decided, being the Giant that I am, I'm gonna elect my own partner. Because it's like Wolfpack. It's just like the Wolfpack. Black and white, we make our own rules, and that's the way I like it. Because you know that nobody back there tells me what to do. So right now, I'm going to call out somebody that I think is worthy enough. I'm going to call out Brian Adams. Brian Adams, come on out here and get your belt.
Well, the Giant's making a decision of his own. He's gonna deem that he and Brian Adams are the World Tag Team Champions. Does he have the right to do that?
No, he don't have the right to do that.
Somebody get out the rules here in WCW, please.
The only way you win or lose a belt is in that ring. You just can't make a decision like that. This is another job for JJ. Yeah, you just can't dictate and say, I win the tag belts, I'm gonna give half of these to this guy. You can't do that. Never been done.
These are World Championship Wrestling title belts, WCW belts. Well, it's be interesting to see what the big
First
man says.
First of all, I want each and every one of you to get off your seats, keep your mouths shut, and put your hands together for the new World Tag Team Champions. Now let me tell you something about this man. He could have chose any wrestler in professional wrestling today to be his partner, and it would have been an honor. But nobody quite measured up like Brian Adams did. So let me get right to the point. We're not gonna duck anybody. We're not gonna run from anybody. We'll put these titles on the line anytime, anywhere, because we're just too big, we're just too powerful, and oh yeah, we're just too sweet.
Now, back to business. Sting, if you ever stick your face in my business again, I will be the deciding factor. Now that I'm done with you, Lex, I see that you're real proud with your new friends. Well, I'll tell you what kind of guys Brian and I am. You grab a partner, any partner you want, anywhere you can find him, red and black, and Brian and I will put the belts on the line tonight, right here on Monday.
Right.
So don't sing it. Bring it.
Very confident challenge from the Giant and Brian Adams, the self-proclaimed World Tag Team Champions. A challenge to Lex Luger of NWO Wolfpack. We'll have more on an explosive thunder after this. I'm out. All right, Lee, thanks a lot. We saw the Giant out here earlier claiming that he and Brian Adams were the World Tag Team Champs. I think there's no question that over the past couple of weeks, the main man, the catalyst of NWO Wolfpack, was the man who first stepped across the line. And I want to bring him out at this time. A lot of questions, hopefully a lot of answers. Please welcome with me here in Peoria, now a member of NWO Wolfpack, the Total Package, Lex Luger.
They got the signs out, red and black attack. They're behind them.
Oh, yeah. Look at his face, Brady. He looks both confident and comfortable with the decision to go Wolfpack.
Well, he's a man's man, Luger. He makes the decision. He stands by it. He's made a decision to join the red and black NWO, and he seems confident and very happy with the decision he's made. I never thought I'd see it.
Total Package making his way up to meet Tony Schiavone in the middle of the ring. And earlier in this program, Brain, we heard Brian Adams, we heard the Giant making the challenge to the Package. Like I said, you call the Package out, you can be guaranteed you're going to get an answer, that's for sure. Tony's going to get it tonight, I know it.
One way or the other.
All right, Lex Luger. I don't know where to start here, but let me say this. There's a lot that has been going on in our sport, and obviously your decision to go NWO Wolfpack leveled all of us in WCW a few weeks back. And then just this past Monday, Sting comes out, tears away the white and the black, and becomes the red and the black. He's your closest friend. Give us your opinion, your thoughts on what happened this past Monday.
Well, first of all, Tony, I was going to do a little survey, but after that reception for the Red and Black and the Wolfpack attack from this crowd right here, it'd be really, really redundant. So let's get right down to business. The momentum grows each and every hour, each and every minute for the Red and Black. Monday night was absolutely huge for the Wolfpack when the Stinger came on board and put on the colors. Now, because of that, Tony, the Wolfpack has gotten together. Now, I'm a little embarrassed by this because I'm getting a lot of the credit it was all of us who did it, but because Sting came on board, the Wolfpack has assigned me as head of recruitment for the Red and Black. Now, I heard the Giant out here earlier. He seems just a little bit angry at what happened. He's making his own rules, and he's making his own matches. He's making his own challenges. Well, Giant, let me think about it. I accept your challenge tonight for the World Tag Team titles.
A partner, though.
Now, my partner ties into this recruitment thing I just talked about, because I take that job very seriously. I'm going to begin right here tonight. Now, the man I want as my partner may be a bit of a surprise. Well, he's a man who just a couple years ago, I would have said, if you asked me for career advice, I would have said, keep your day job. But he has made the most rapid ascension I've ever seen in our sport. His determination, his work ethic, his tenacity, and his energy level have made him truly one of the biggest stars in our sport today. No question about it. And that man I'm talking about, the man who I want for my partner tonight, goes by this.
What?
Whoa! Diamond Cutter!
And they already know what that means.
Yes, they do. You're talking about Diamond Dallas Page of WCW.
You know, I know, and obviously they know. Now, Dallas, Stinger just took the step. Now it's your turn to step into the light and bathe in the warmth of the Red and Black and the NWO. So Dallas, tonight two things will happen. You wrestle with me, we will be wearing at the end of the night the World Tag Team titles. And the second thing that's gonna happen is after we win the titles, I got another present for you in the back. It's a red and black shirt with your name on it. Think about it.
We'll have more live on Thunder right after this. Oh, my goodness.
He's recruiting.
Bryan Adams drives a knee, and if you're wondering at home, why is DDP siding or teaming now with Lex Luger of NWO Wolfpack? Well, think back now, and I don't want to try to rationalize too much about what's going on in our sport, but when the NWO first came on the scene, their mission, their statement, was to destroy tradition, destroy WCW, and have everything NWO. From the NWO Wolfpack side, that has really not been established yet. They've Luger's, not really, Luger's bouncing back to the eyes. Does Bryan Adams pick up? And a backbreaker. Bryan Adams is too strong.
Tony, that's a great point that you just made, because if you think back, it was even Kevin Nash a couple of weeks ago that came out to save Sting.
Here's, but there's no Lex Luger.
They can lock.
Tag is into Bryan Adams, but Luger makes it to the corner. Here comes Page on fire.
Oh, you aren't kidding, Mike.
DDP!
both off.
He's knocked the Giant off the apron almost.
Page.
He's going to go for it.
Oh, my goodness. One big arm. Grabbing the hair, throwing the man down. Ended that.
That put a halt to all the momentum. Wait a minute. Here comes that Sting.
Sting is here.
Sting wearing the red face paint. Gets the Giant.
Diamond Cutter.
Diamond Cutter. One, two, three, it's over.
There's new tag team champions.
New champions, can you believe it?
New tag team champions.
And it's Lex Luger, and there's Sting. That is Sting of NWO Wolfpack and Diamond Dallas Page.
They've got the belts in their hand. The Giant doesn't know what to think of this. Careful, you ask for it, you may get what you ask for.
Did you see his face? The Giant's face. New World Tag Team Champions. One member of NWO Wolfpack, one of WCW. All right, we understand immediately on the 1-2-3, James J. Dillon has placed a phone call here to our video unit, and we are attempting now to patch James J. Dillon in here live on Thunder. All right, we do have JJ. I've been told that JJ, hello.
Tony, hello, Tony.
Can you hear me, James J.
Dillon? Yes, we're having severe weather problems here in Atlanta, but I'm glad I've been able to get through to you.
All right, you saw what happened. Lex Luger and Diamond Dallas Page are World Tag Team Champions.
Tony, hold on right there. I'm at CNN Center tonight. We've had a session with the executive committee, and we took a recess for 2 hours to watch Thunder on the Superstation with millions of other people across the country. So we've seen everything that took place. And I want to first congratulate Lex Luger and Diamond Dallas Page on a tremendous victory. But, Tony, we have a huge problem here.
Okay, what's that, James?
Well, I don't know where the Giant thinks he has the authority to select another partner other than Sting and declare themselves as champion and start making matches, including title defenses.
That seems logical. I can understand that.
Yes, and so this is a huge problem that requires an instant solution. So we've had a quick vote here among the executive committee. It's obvious that there are differences between Sting and the Giant. We're not going to be able to get them back in the ring to legitimately defend the titles as a team.
Right.
So we are ordering, the executive committee is ordering, that the Giant appear at the Great American Bash pay-per-view on Sunday, June 14th in Baltimore. And we are ordering that he face one-on-one Sting.
Whoa.
And the winner of that match will leave the ring with both belts, and then will legitimately be able to determine who they want for a tag team partner. We will recognize them as champions, and then they will have the authority to sign for a title match, which we will sanction at that time. So, Tony, it's official from the executive committee at the Great American Bash, Sunday, June 14th, one-on-one, Sting versus the Giant.
So I guess we can assume that even though it was a great victory, Luger and Diamond Dallas Page cannot rightfully claim that they're World Tag Team Champions.
Tony, I'm very disappointed that it's worked out this way, but I hope it'll all be sorted out at the Great American Bash.
Well, they'll try to sort it out. James J. Dillon, I know you're a very, very busy man. Thank you very much for your telephone call from the offices at the CNN Center downtown Atlanta. Diamond Dallas Page and Lex Luger win tonight. However, because of the circumstances, they cannot lay claim to the World Tag Team Championship. Sting and the Giant have been signed for the Great American Bash in a mere 10 days. And that winner will be able to take the belts and decide what to do with them.
That seems like the way to settle it, Tony.
And what a tag match.
Wow,
Hogan, Hart, Piper, Savage.
And it's all coming up in 10 days at the Great American Bash. We're going to see you Saturday for 2 hours of WCW Saturday night. You see the Diamond Cutter, what a move that is. And we'll see you live 3 hours of WCW Monday Nitro this Monday on TNT. For Lee Marshall, for Iron Mike Tenay, for the Weasel, Bobby the Brain Heenan, of course. I'm Tony Schiavone. Have a good night, everybody.
Ow.
Okay, Mike Tenay and Living Legend Larry Zbyszko, we were all in Peoria, Illinois this past Thursday for Thunder when Diamond Dallas Page and Lex Luger won the match, thought they were World Tag Team Champions. You made the statement from your office at the CNN Center in downtown Atlanta, and of course that has led to another big match sign coming up at the Great American Bash this Sunday, James.
Well, Tony, last Thursday I tried for quite some time to get through on the lines because we had bad weather, communication problems from the Atlanta end. I tried to get through and put the match to a stop before it ever even got started, because actually the Giant had no authority whatsoever to pick anyone that he wanted to be his partner that night, declare themselves champion, start making matches and title matches on top of that. And really what happened after that is unfortunate for Lex Luger and Diamond Dallas Page, because I was sincere when I congratulated them on a great match, but the thing is that the match should never have taken place in the first place.
So now we have Sting of NWO Wolfpack, the Giant of NWO Hollywood, as you said, one-on-one coming up this Sunday at the Great American Bash, and they got some really has a big impact on the World Tag Team Championship.
Exactly right, because it was obvious that we were never going to get the two of them together to defend the titles. Those differences were beyond repair. So the executive committee said, let's have them meet one-on-one. Whoever walks away that night has both championship belts, then can pick who he wants for a partner. WCW will then recognize them as the new tag team champions. They can then rightfully defend the titles, will sanction the match, and that should put this issue to rest.
It's got to be the first time ever in pro wrestling anything like this has happened, and that had to be a tough decision for you.
I never remember anything like this, but it really seemed like the only way to go. So the Great American Bash this coming Sunday, someone's walking away with both belts.
It will be Sting against the Giant this Sunday. Whoever wins will have both belts, be able to choose his own partner, and become World Tag Team Champion. Let's go back to action here live on Nitro.
It's not nearly the amount of fun that I'm going to have on Sunday, Giant, watching what you're going to do to the Wolfpack's big deal, the Stinger. Now, I know you haven't eaten anything in 4 days, because I know you want to have a hell of an appetite when you get to the pay-per-view, but settle down a little bit and tell me a little bit about your diet come Sunday.
You know, my diet Sunday, I think it's going to be a combination of a lot of bugs. Right now, a little red and black bug sounds good to me. Because you know, Sting, when I think about it, everybody fought so long for you. And now that I sit back and think about it, why? What are you compared to a 7'4", 510-pound, very upset Giant?
I can help you with that. As long as we're talking about bugs, what is he compared to you? For $500, another bottle of Dom Perignon, let me see. He's a gnat.
A gnat, that's a good word. And what do you do to a gnat or an insect or a fly or a bug when you catch it? You start pulling its limbs off. And Sting, come Sunday, I'm gonna pull an arm off. I'm gonna pull a leg off. I'm gonna floss my teeth. And with whatever limb I have in my hands, I'm gonna pummel you to death right in the middle of the ring and beat you like the chicken coward you are.
Easy, big man. You're killing everybody's buzz here. We'll be back. Don't anybody leave us. Hollywood and Rodzilla are going to be back, too. Oh, boy. You're not leaving, are you? Oh, I'm so glad you know that.
Here we go.
Woo! That is what you call an official Wolfpack howl, just for you, big old Giant. I hate to be cliche-ish, but please, Giant, don't let your mouth override your big fat your big fat booty, okay? I got news for you. At the very first Great American Bash, I had blonde hair. I was a nice guy. I was kind of a brat, but I was still as a brat beating up big guys just like you. Now that I've grown my hair out nice and long, and I've become a seasoned veteran, I've become a whole lot meaner also. So you say you're gonna use the Stinger as dental floss. Why don't you start by taking a shower and work your way on down from there? Because you stink. Get off of the champagne. Get rid of the girls. Stop smoking those cigarettes because you're looking a little bit out of shape. I'm telling you right now, along with being a lot meaner and a seasoned veteran, I become a little cocky too. I'm just gonna go ahead and tell you right now, I got your number. I'm either gonna hook you in a Scorpion Deathlock or I'm gonna Scorpion Death drop you. Either way, at the Great American Bash, I own you. Woo! Thank you, Tony. It's nice to talk again.
It's now crunch time. DDP, I know you're gonna make the right decision tonight. So come on out and take the colors of the Wolfpack.
All right, he wants to cut the music. There they are. And we know what happened Thursday on Thunder when you stepped up to team with Lex Luger, but what will your decision be?
Here in the Motor City, even from you, Savage. You know, Nash, when you hopped off that Black and White Express and got away from Hollywood scum Hogan, you reminded me of the guy I used to go up and down the roads with. The guy who made me laugh had a big heart. And you showed that to me by taking K-Dog with you, because he was your boy there, and he came with you. Bang. And then you let Hennigan and even Savage, four of the greatest athletes on the planet, I seen what you were doing. But man, when you got Lex Luger, that blew my mind. And when he brought Stinger in, well, that you want me now, man, makes me feel something right here. I can't believe I'm gonna do this.
Man,
there's nothing more important.
Oh my goodness.
That was Rodman.
Signing him good, right from behind. Oh, listen to that.
Just when he was gonna make that decision.
Oh, he's hurt. He just got back after getting those ribs. They were injured all that for 6-7 months or so. Now he was 100% healthy, we thought, but look at him now.
We can see the concern of the other NWO Wolfpack members.
There was Rodman and Hogan, man.
Don't forget, Thunder, this Thursday on TBS.
Mario Schiavone, Bobby Heenan.
What?
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Buffalo.
Didn't we do that already?
You know, one of the greatest quarterbacks of all time is here tonight. Jim Kelly is here for the same reason each and every one of you are here, and that's because we're here. And we want to thank you all from the bottoms of our hearts. But you know, as I sit here surrounded by the things that are most important to me, and I look back at where we've come from and where we are now, it only makes me wonder, where the hell are we going to go next? My new assistant to the president here has been helping me kind of reorganize my company, if you know what I mean. But
The thing that intrigues me the most, Giant, is that J.J. Dillon has actually set the stage for you to choose who you want as your tag team partner to be the new World Tag Team Champions. And I'd like to get your feelings on that.
You know, the cards couldn't be laid on the table any better than they are. You know, basically, all I have to do is exactly what I'm going to do. You take, after Sunday, after I've beaten Sting with the chokeslam, right in the middle, whether he drops down out of the sky and I slap him out of the air, he comes up through the ring, I step on him and squash him like a bug. Either way, I beat Sting, then I get to pick my partner. I don't think it gets any better than that. Now, when you really sit back and you think about being the World Tag Team Champion belt holder that I am, I've got both belts. Both belts are mine. You know, and there's a lot of people that call, and there's a lot of people that interview, a lot of people want to be my partner. You know, I've had to sit back and think about it. And I need somebody that's intense. I need somebody that's built hard as a rock. I know you're busy. You know, I thought about you. But, you know, you're running the NWO, and right now you're the first and the last name in wrestling. So I had to find another partner. Somebody that's got a devastating finish move. Susie grabs him and knocks him out cold. Something like an apocalypse. And there's only one person I can think of. Big D the Disciple!
Hey, everybody, welcome the new World Tag Team Champions, the Disciple and the Giant, coming up this Sunday. Take a look at this.
Now, did I pick a partner? This guy is lean, mean, he's a killing machine. So anybody else who wants to step up and get a piece of us, well, I tell you what, I'm already the World Tag Team Champion. They're my belts. Brutus, right here, my man, the Disciple, the big guy, he's my partner. You know what, Dallas, Lex, everybody else in the back, you guys want to run your mouth? You know what, Lex, an idea for you. Why don't you grab a partner? Grab anybody you want to. I don't care who it is. Grab anybody. I don't care. Disciple and I right here tonight, we'll cancel you like a bad check. Because what doesn't get chokeslam is going to meet the apocalypse.
And one last thing before we get to the action here, before we join our party. Guys up at the announce booth, how dare you think that you can jump the gun on any announcements concerning Mr. Rodman and Mr. Hogan? Can it? Our attorney, Mr. Henry Holmes, has put an end to that. Thank you very much. Carry on with our show and let us enjoy our party. We love you!
Okay, Lee Marshall, thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, truly this man I'm about to bring out is one of the most influential, one of the most successful athletes in the entire wrestling world. And now he's a member of the Red and the Black and obviously their top recruiter. Here is the total package, Lex Luger.
And Tony's right about that. Talk about a recruiter. He's the one that got Sting to put on the black and red along with the big giant killer, big sexy Kevin Nash. I'll tell you, if you had to pick a side, the black or the red and black, I'd have to go probably with the red and black.
Very convincing, like you said, Brain. He managed to talk Sting into becoming part of the Wolfpack and then immediately starting the recruiting process on Diamond Dallas Page. Why not? If you can recruit Sting, you could probably recruit anybody.
Yeah, but like Tony says, you know, with all Hogan's money and pulling, Bischoff's brains and knowledge, the NWO white and black is trouble too.
All right, Lex Luger, the last time we saw you on this program, you had asked Diamond Dallas Page to be your partner, and he came out, and you guys won the match, thinking you had won the World Tag Team Championship. Let me get your thoughts on what happened last week.
You know, I hate to be a party crasher on Hollywood and the NWO, but they seem to be missing, because the Wolfpack, they must have got word, is definitely in the house here in Buffalo. But you know, Tony, it really doesn't surprise me that I'm out here right now, because they probably got word I was coming out, and face-to-face confrontations aren't really your style, are they? Especially after Monday night, because it's usually from behind with a chair. Now, DDP, I know you got a lot on your mind, but I want to let you know on behalf of myself and the entire Wolfpack, there's still a red and black shirt with your name on it, and the door is still wide open.
Lex, let's take a look at what happened 1 week ago on this program when Diamond Dallas Page and Lex Luger were tag team. Let's take a look. All right, Lex, we're watching this. And you can see here that Diamond Dallas Page makes a cover and gets the 1-2-3.
Gee whiz, I guess he didn't get the belts there, did they?
Well, obviously, at that time, we all thought you guys were the World Tag Team Champs. And now the Giant, here tonight, right over to our right, when they were having their party, says when he beats Sting coming up on Sunday, that he and the Disciple will be the World Tag Team Champs. And he also has issued a blanket challenge for tonight's program.
Well, I guess I say a picture's worth a thousand words, and we just saw it. But Giant, if you want to continue this folly, because you know after Sunday, you'll be making no decisions when Sting's done with you in the Great American Bash. But if you want to make a decision tonight, if you want to issue a challenge, if you want to try out another partner, well, the Total Package Lex Luger and the Wolf Pack is going to take you up on that challenge right here tonight in Buffalo, live on Thunder. Now, after what happened on Monday night with DDP, the Wolfpack lined up, and even WCW guys in the back lined up after they heard the Giant make the challenge. But tonight, it's going to be the Macho Man and the Total Package.
Wow.
And we're going to give the Giant and the Disciple a little warm-up match, Wolfpack style.
How about that? Luger and the Macho Man Randy Savage against the Giant and the Disciple later on tonight. And more live from Buffalo, New York, after this timeout on TBS.
Short walk.
And immediately the bell sounds because these four athletes are pounding away. You are looking live and in color, so to speak, at the animosity that is built up between these sides of the New World Order. Power struggle, yes. More than just that, though. Oh, my! The Disciple was wiped out.
Hey! Macho Man. I think I got what you're looking for. You want a piece of me? You want her? Come and get it. Come on, you chump.
He's baiting the Macho Man. He wants the Macho Man to come towards you.
Well, he's smarter than that.
And, of course, that leap. Is he? It leaves Luger all alone.
Yeah, but Luger's doing pretty well for himself, Tony.
Bischoff's a nut. He's going to challenge Randy Savage. And look at this.
The Disciple's up in the torture rack.
It's Bret Hart has come out of the limousine.
They set him up.
And look. Hollywood Hogan. That's his first appearance of the night. He came from the other side of the limousine.
And Elizabeth just stands in the back and watches.
Yeah, we see the master plan of the NWO black and white unfold right before our eyes. That's Kevin Nash.
Kevin Nash has come out to help Randy Savage. And this fight has erupted like never before. Oh, my goodness. Trying to pick up Hollywood Hogan. The Giant's there at the limousine.
The Giant went right after Nash.